The main display is the primary feature of the device, right? And so we want that to be the first thing users experience. It's mind-blowing the first time you fold a foldable device, and you just gain a strong appreciation for it.
Welcome to the Made by Google podcast, where we meet the people who work on the Google products you love. Here's your host, Rachid Finge.
Unfolding Pixel 10 Pro Fold is a magical experience. What goes into building such a device, from the inner and outer displays, the brand new hinge, and the best durability to date? Let's learn more from Pixel 10 Pro Fold's product manager, Jeff Evans.
This is the Made by Google podcast.
Jeff, as the product manager of a foldable device, whenever you see a hinge in the real world, did your appreciation change for it?
That's a great question. Absolutely. Yeah, you take it for granted, you know, in a car door or a door going into your home or opening a cupboard, like there's hinges all over. The hinge that we have built for the Pixel 10 Pro Fold is on a whole nother scale. This year we introduced this new gearless hinge, which is a complete re-architecture of our hinge mechanism from the Pixel 9 Pro Fold.
I'm thinking there's probably no one who knows more about advanced hinges than you.
I don't know about that. Definitely a team effort. There's a lot of very smart folks working on the hinges, but I know a lot about hinges. Definitely not something on my five-year plan 5 years ago to be a hinge expert, but glad to be here.
So let's back up a little. You joined Google 3 years ago, but you worked in consumer devices before. So how did you start out?
Yeah, so I started out my career actually in like a strategy type role where I was doing internal consulting for a smart home company. And we were looking at a bunch of new opportunities for the business, new verticals where we could sell our, you know, home security and smart home devices into. A few short years into that, the company asked me to join the product management team officially, but on a different product. And I was the doorbell camera product manager. So my first like hardware device was a doorbell camera. And it was a ton of fun. You know, I never really thought I'd be like a camera person or a hinge person.
Or a doorbell person, right?
Or a doorbell person.
So then you joined Google 3 years ago. And I told you this before. You then created one of my favorite Google hardware products of all time, which is the Pixel tablet case. Now, this might sound totally random to most people, but there were some important challenges to solve there. Can you explain what you had to do to make this a really great case for a Pixel tablet?
Yeah. So the if I can back up just a little bit, the Pixel tablet was created with another really strong like pain point in mind, which was, you know, we recognize that tablets spend most of their life in a drawer or unplugged. And then when you use that larger screen to watch Netflix or shop or do some work, you'd pull it out of the drawer, blow the dust off, and it'd be out of battery, right? And this happened so often. So we built this tablet with that pain point in mind. And of course, we built, you know, this charging speaker dock that came in the box with the tablet originally. And so you could, when you're done using the tablet, you dock the tablet onto this speaker. It would keep it charged. And then also, it would transform your tablet into a smart display. So you could play music or ask Google Assistant, you know, questions. And then we also knew from research with our consumers that almost all tablet cases have some sort of a kickstand or propping mechanism. And so we spent a ton of time and iteration trying to figure out what is the exact right recipe to preserve the docking onto the charging speaker dock and provide a kickstand mechanism. And we came up with this really interesting and beautiful and really well-received ring that actually just fits right around the dock when you dock the tablet to it. But then also doubles as this really elegant kickstand. Customers loved it. I think like we saw lots of press articles about the Pixel tablet case and just how much of an impact that made on the overall usability and enjoyment of the tablet. And so, you know, it's simple, right? It's like it's a case, but we really spent so much time and we were still trying to solve these customer pain points. And it just was like a reinforcement to me as a PM that like even on seemingly tangential or accessory devices, it's not the main thing, right? It's not the tablet or the speaker dock. It's the case, but you put a little bit of extra effort into it and it goes a really long way. And so that was a great reminder to me that that extra effort is always worth it when we're building products for our users.
And mind you, your first foray into hinges, right? Because that was obviously part of the kickstand. So you then moved on to a Pixel 10 Pro Fold specifically, just as the Pixel 9 series launched. So what is the first thing you did when you joined the team?
Well, the first thing I did was ask for a fold. I was like, I got to get my hands on this device. First thing that surprised me was that it ships unfolded. So that's, that was just kind of strange. Like it ships, you know, completely unfolded. And again, I'd never opened the box before. And so when you first hold it, it's this like pristine 8-inch screen. And I was so nervous to fold it the first time. Cause it was just like, it's really mind blowing. Like it's completely like counterintuitive, I think, for me in terms of, you know, this is a glass display.
Is that the reason why it's shipped unfolded, or is there another reason for that?
Yeah, I mean, the main display is the primary feature of the device, right? And so we want that to be the first thing users experience. We want them to go through this same kind of almost emotional event with their phone. I know that kind of sounds cheesy or whatever, but like it really is like it's mind-blowing the first time you fold a foldable device. And you just gain a strong appreciation for it. And so we ship it unfolded.
So Pixel 10 Pro Fold, what would you say are sort of the headlines for this beautiful foldable phone?
Yeah, the Pixel 10 Pro Fold, it is a complete step change in so many different ways from the Pixel 9 Pro Fold. We've talked about the hinge, but this new gearless hinge really is a marvel. It's a huge cross-functional effort across engineering, design, our testers that we give the phone to prior to it going on shelf. Like it just across the board took so many hands to make sure this device could uphold to, you know, the strains of everyday life. And it has the best battery and charging capabilities yet. So it has a 5,000 milliamp battery, which we're able to squeeze into the same footprint as our last generation. So that took a lot of engineering effort to maximize the battery space. But then also the introduction, this is probably honestly my favorite feature of the device this year, which is, thankfully, it's across the portfolio, but it's PixelSnap.
Yeah, that's right.
The integration of the Qi2 magnets, it's a game changer. Like it makes it so much more enjoyable and convenient to charge and use on a daily basis.
Now, I know you cannot see me as we're recording this, but I'm showing this to our viewers. So I have a Pixel 10 Pro Fold here. But then the magnets are only, when it's unfolded, they're only on one side of the device, right? And still, it should be able to sort of be attached while not sort of sliding down, I guess?
That's right. Yeah, they're not centered. So the magnets all reside on kind of the backside of the phone. And so, which is great. When the phone is folded, you can easily go into landscape or portrait mode on a PixelSnap charger or a Qi2 compatible charger. But as soon as you unfold it, that's where the challenge really comes because it is so imbalanced, as you mentioned. And so the team spent, you know, countless hours optimizing the magnets and the strength and the thickness of the magnets. Every little detail you can imagine on both the phone side as well as on our first party accessories. So like the PixelSnap charger with stand, for example, we spent so many hours making sure that you could unfold the phone, dock it, and so that it wouldn't droop down as you docked in. So we're really proud of the results. It's a fantastic experience, and it enables this really rich experience where, very much like the tablet that I was able to work on earlier, as soon as you dock it, it turns into this really rich display where you can have your photos, you can have a simple clock, you can have weather or home control widgets, all sorts of use cases that you can now use your phone for, even when it's just there charging.
So when you're working on PixelSnap, integrating that into Pixel 10 Pro Fold, is that like just every day you're just going to try magnets with a slightly different strength until you sort of find the ideal one? Is it a matter of a lot of calculations? I'm just wondering, you know, I just can see someone trying a new device every day with a little change until it's perfect, but I'm not sure what the reality is.
I mean, that's it. Relatively early on in the build process, you know, when we were getting into our proto phases or our EVT builds, we have a bunch of different, we call them DOEs, different options or different layouts for various functions and features. And one of those would be Qi2 magnets. So we would have multiple different layouts that we would test. We would run through reliability tests. We would run through user tests. And then ultimately we would narrow down onto a set of magnets that works for us, that works the best for our users. But yeah, I mean, it is extremely detailed. Like we're talking about, you know, changes on the magnets of, you know, sub-millimeter changes here and there to just really fine-tune and optimize both, again, the accessory side as well as the phone side.
There's something else with Pixel 10 Pro Fold. It's called IP68. It's durability, making sure that Pixel 10 Pro Fold is durable. So what is IP68? Let's start there for people who don't exactly know. And some people, I guess, kind of heard it, but they don't really know what those two numbers mean. Could you explain it a little bit?
Right. Yeah. On most consumer electronic devices, I'd say you'll see, if you look into the tech specs, you'll see some kind of an IP rating. This is especially true for things like phones and tablets and devices you carry around and use in various environments, right? But what this is an ingress protection rating. And so it's a third party standard that establishes the first number. So IP6 in this case references our dust ingress protection rating. And then the second number, the 8, is the water ingress protection rating. The Pixel 9 Pro Fold had an IPX8 IP rating. So we actually didn't claim a dust ingress protection rating. However, for the Pixel 10 Pro Fold, this is the first foldable that's IP68 rated, which is the same IP rating that you'll find on the other Pixel 10 phones that we launched this year. So this is monumental for a foldable. Again, it's the first foldable to achieve this rating. And it was so important for us because, of course, we wanted to. We want to protect the device. We want them to last longer. We want users to have that peace of mind. But we really saw it as well from our users that, especially those who wanted a foldable but were on the fence and not quite there yet, when we asked these users, hey, what would get you to reconsider or to make the leap into fold? I can't remember the number off the top of my head, but like a vast majority of those users stated, hey, if we could have the same durability as a normal phone, the same dust and water ingress protection, a hinge that lasted 10 years, which is another thing we were able to achieve this year. Those are big ticket items that they were kind of looking for to help them get over that hump of, you know, understanding that it's an expensive device and there's some concern naturally with its fragility. So we spent a ton of time on Pixel 10 Pro Fold to make sure that we closed that gap just as much as we possibly could.
Now, Jeff, there's so many ways to use Pixel 10 Pro Fold. Of course, you can use it folded in a portrait and landscape. You can then unfold it, but you can also use it as sort of a tent. And then you have tabletop mode. Just wondering, from the product manager, what is your favorite mode on Pixel 10 Pro Fold? How do you use it mostly?
I mean, it's hard to beat having it unfolded. Of course, I use it folded most of the time. Just, you know, I'm checking a message, responding to a quick email. That's folded, and that's what that outer display is really great for. But, you know, I got lots of responsibilities at home. I have responsibilities, obviously, here at work and at the office. And a lot of times I have to multitask. And so opening that display and being able to have multiple apps that I need at that moment side by side and being able to quickly jump between the two, it sounds like not that big of a deal, but once you experience it, it really does like elevate your productivity. And so I'd have to say just completely unfolded. I will say I'm guilty of keeping it in tabletop mode and watching YouTube a fair amount, much to my wife's chagrin at times. I do love consuming media in tabletop mode where I can, you know, I can be on my laptop and have a show running or get a news update or whatever the case may be.
Yeah, and for people who never used a foldable like that, so when it's in tabletop mode, it kind of looks like a laptop, and then the sort of bottom part on the screen changes into media controls, right?
Yeah, there's a lot of apps that have been optimized for these different postures that the phone can go into. And so YouTube is, of course, a great example where, yeah, if you put it in tabletop mode, you'll get a nice, you know, widescreen view on the top half of that screen, and then on the bottom, it'll turn into, yeah, your media controls, or you can swipe through it and open up, you know, comments on the video or whatever, just so you can preserve that screen.
Jeff, there's something new in the camera as well on Pixel 10 Pro Fold exclusively, Instant View, which I wanted to ask you about. But maybe if you'd indulge me, we can start with my favorite feature, probably of all of Pixel 10 Pro Fold, which is Made You Look.
Yeah, I knew what you were going to say. That's why
all parents probably tell you that.
Absolutely, like one of the favorite features, especially for those with, you know, with little ones. For those who aren't familiar, Made You Look, when you unfold the phone so that the people you're taking the photo of can see the outer display, it'll play, you know, this really fun, there's a set of them, but there's an animation that will play. And it doesn't just play to like get the, you know, the people you're taking a photo of to look at the camera, but it also uses AI to recognize when the people you're taking a photo of are smiling.
Oh, really?
Or react, yeah.
Oh, I had no clue.
And you'll notice that the animations will actually react to that. So not only does it like capture people's attention, but it also keeps it, which is really critical for taking the right photo, right? It's just a super fun feature. So this year we launched two new animations So there's, I think there's 6 animations total at this point that users can select from. And again, yeah, I have 3 kids of my own, and very frequently, if I'm taking a photo of them, they request.
Exactly. That's my experience too. They want to see it. Yeah.
Yeah. I want to see the cat in the fishbowl or whatever. Yeah, it's really a super fun feature. And again, only possible on this flexible form factor in the Pixel Fold.
And then Instant View, new for this year. Do you know how that came about and when you tried it yourself for the first time?
Yeah, again, I think, you know, this is a great example of like when you have this big display, we're trying to push beyond just like, oh, you know, just make the apps bigger or make them, you know, just fill the whole screen. It's like, no, we're actually trying to add a lot of new features and value with this extra space. And so what Instant View does is you can open the phone, open the camera app, turn on Instant View, and you see your viewfinder on one side, and then you see your recently taken photos on the left side. And what this does is it just enables you to have confidence that you got that perfect shot you're looking for. And so as you take photos or videos, it just pops up there on the left-hand side. And as you keep taking them, they scroll down, and you can scroll through them, you can share them, you can tap into them to edit. It just really like provides a layer of richness. And I think, yeah, for users, like this level of confidence that they're preserving that moment in the way that they intended to without having to jump back and forth between screens or apps.
I guess when you get your phone out of your pocket and you unfold it, there might be people around who've never seen something like that before. Do you remember like the funniest encounter or one that stayed with you for whatever reason when you did that and you had that response from someone?
I do remember one time I was on a trip with one of my really great childhood friends. So me and him go back, you know, to like kindergarten, that type of a friend. And I showed him the Pixel 9 Pro Fold. He's always had, you know, like the Pro XL sized phones or the ultra size phones, like these big phones, because he just likes having big screen, good cameras, all that stuff. And when I showed him, like, hey, this is what I'm working on at Google, or, you know, and he opened it and he unfolded it. And like visibly, you could tell on his face, just like the excitement and like how much of like a game changer it was for him. And that image is like going to be, it's burned in my head or in my mind forever. I think he was just so excited to see this. And it mirrored my own experience, which I think I remembered it so well. It was sort of my same reaction, right? When I first got my hands onto the Pixel 9 Pro Fold, like it really is such a magical device. And I hope everyone can get the chance to try it out.
Jeff, thank you so much for joining the Made by Google podcast. And hopefully we'll have you back on, well, next year when there's maybe a new foldable phone.
I'd love to. I'm looking forward to it. Thanks so much for the time.
Thank you for listening to the Made by Google podcast. Don't miss out on new episodes. Subscribe now wherever you get your podcasts to be the first to listen.